This is part 5 of a series on CNN. In this video, we will look at the 3D convolution. 3D convolution can be used for 3D image slices, such as medical imaging, or for videos, such as action recognition data. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice is generated by AI, text-to-speech. In the last video, we looked at the residual neural network using 2D convolution. In this video, we will look at 3D convolution and use it to build a 3D residual neural network to classify 3D MNIST images. Let's look at the 3D convolution process. We looked at the 2D convolution in the previous video. The 3D convolution is similar to this process. The only difference is that the dimensions of the input data, filters, and feature maps are increased by 1, and the filters move to 3 dimensions. The input data is a 3D RGB image, such as a 3D CT scan image. This example is a 3D MNIST image with the target Y of 3. This image has a 4-dimensional structure like this. It has the width, height, and depth dimensions, and the last dimension is the number of RGB channels. Multiple 3D RGB images have a 5-dimensional structure, containing the number of images. The first dimension is the batch size, i.e. the number of 3D images, and the last dimension is the number of channels. Channels can be placed in the second dimension of an array, but are typically placed in the last dimension. A 4D image cannot be represented in 3-dimensional space, but can be depicted with multiple 3D images for each RGB channel, as follows. This is a representation of a single 4D RGB image with 3 channels. This corresponds to a 2D RGB image in the 2D convolution example. And there is one filter with a 4D structure. There is one 3D filter per channel. This corresponds to the first filter in the 2D convolution example. Each 3D filter is applied to each channel of the 3D image. This 3D filter computes cross-correlations while scanning each 3D image in 3 directions to obtain the value of each voxel in the feature map. This will produce 3 feature maps like this. We sum these 3 feature maps element-wise, just like we did in the 2D convolution. Then we can get a single feature map like this. This is the feature map obtained using the first filter. This corresponds to the first yellow feature map in the 2D convolution example. You can add a bias here. The second and third filters also generate their own feature maps. Combining these feature maps into a single 4D structure produces the final feature map, which is the output of the 3D convolutional layer. This has the same dimensions as the input image. The last dimension is the number of filters. If we add the batch dimension here, it becomes 5-dimensional. Therefore, the feature maps of multiple 3D RGB images have a 5-dimensional structure. This feature map can be fed into the next 3D convolutional layer or 3D pooling layer. A 3D pooling layer is just a 2D pooling layer with one more dimension. I will skip the explanation for this. Next, let's take a look at the 3D MNIST dataset. This is a 3D version of the MNIST database of handwritten digits. This dataset is available for download from this site. The aim of this dataset is to provide a simple way to get started with 3D computer vision problems such as 3D shape recognition. There is another dataset called Augmented 3D MNIST. This is the 3D version of MNIST with augmented features like rotation and colors. This dataset can be downloaded from this site. The following transformations are applied in order to generate a 3D digit from a 2D image. This example shows a three-dimensional image of the digit 3. The first step is dilating. In this step, the original image is stacked 28 times to create a 3D grid. In the second step, Gaussian noise is added to non-zero values in each layer of the stack. In the third step, colors are added to the 3D data using some random Python color map. The final step is reducing size and rotating. In this step, each image will be resized to 16 by 16 by 16 and rotated XYZ axes by random small angles. A single image has a four-dimensional structure like this, including color channels. Next, let's visually examine the 3D MNIST images. The source of this code is this site. And the source of the data is this site. Load the dataset downloaded from this site. This is a file in HDF5 format. This dataset contains 60,000 training data points and 10,000 test data points with dimensions of 16 by 16 by 16 by 3. And we have the target Y, which consists of 10 categories. We use this function to visualize a 3D MNIST image. This code was taken from this site. The 3D MNIST images are as follows. This image is a 3D representation of the digit 3. And this image is the digit 6. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. This is the digit 2. Next, we will classify 3D MNIST images using residual network, which we looked at in the previous video. Let's design a ResNet 14 model, which is a residual network model, for the case where n is 2. This model has three sets of layers. For more information about the residual network, please watch the previous video. In the previous video, we built a residual network model using 2D convolution and 2D pooling to classify CIFAR-10 images. In this video, we will build a residual network model using 3D convolution and 3D pooling to classify 3D MNIST images. The input image has dimensions 16 by 16 by 16 by 3. We apply 16 filters of size 3 by 3 by 3 to the input image. Then the output dimensions of the first set of layers will be like this. Since we use 3D convolution, the output of each layer is four-dimensional, excluding the batch dimension. In this way, we also create the second and third sets of layers. The final output dimensions are 4x4x4x64. And then we do 3D global average pooling. Finally, the feedforward network classifies the input image into 10 categories. Excluding the global average pooling layer, there are a total of 14 layers with trainable parameters represented by squares. This is the ResNet 14 model for 3D MNIST image classification. Next, let's implement the ResNet 14 model in code. Build and train a model for the case where n is 2, as shown in the figure on the previous page. Let's write a function that constructs a residual building block. And write a function that builds a ResNet 14 layer. For more information on these functions, please watch the previous video. Load the 3D MNIST dataset. Now we build a ResNet 14 model for 3D MNIST image classification. Create an input layer. The input layer receives five-dimensional data like this. Then we add a ResNet 14 layer and a 3D global average pooling layer. Finally, we add an output layer to classify the input image into 10 categories. Create and compile this model. Fit this model to the training data. The batch size is set to 256, and the number of iterations is set to 50. Next, let's check the loss history. Finally, measure the accuracy of the test data. During training, the training error and the test error are reduced like this. You can see that it learns normally without overfitting. The accuracy of the test data was 0.9902. Let's run this code. It will take some time. We got the following results. This time, the accuracy of the test data is 0.9883. So far, we have looked at 3D convolution and used it to classify 3D MNIST images. In the next video, we will look at the convolutional LSTM.